Hello, this is setting up cash on delivery in 7-Eleven. That's the website we need to have. Also, we can have it from the app. Online mailing. Click that. And then, yeah, click the yellow button. It says, Woyao Chichin. I want to send delivery. It's fast delivery, safe delivery. It says here, and then easy to check. First step is to have the agreement. These are the rates per area. Different places, different, like outside the island, the inter-island, is have different rates. Like Penghu, Kingmen, yeah, have different rates. But within the, I think outside the area, outside the island is 80 NT, and within the island is 40 NT. These are the no kind of package. And then 7-Eleven agreement, okay. And then set up the amount. It says here the amount, total amount and the shipping amount should be not more than 1,000. Because when the package is lost, they will only compensate the value of the package, and that would be only the maximum amount, 1,000. Yeah. The red color there says it's the maximum. Yeah, here. Have this asterisk, the star sign has for your name and Sochi. And then that's very important, especially when you get a return package. Nobody pick it up. And then the Sochi, the telephone number. And the email for the seller. So they will have notification that the buyer already picked up the item. Yeah, that's the example. You key in all your information. This is first the setup for the seller's information. Yeah. This next is for the place where to return the package. This is very important, especially when the package is not received by the buyer or not picked up by the buyer. Okay. Oh yeah, search. It says here like this is the first choices from north to south, Chilong to Kaohsiung, and then out, and then that's the city, county where it belongs, and then you can have these options. And then the Penghu Kingmen outside the island. I find this more easy to do than the other two options. Yeah, these are the districts under the city list of districts. Yeah, and then under district is the road nearest to you. Yeah, okay. And then once you're done searching for the nearest road to you, they will show a specific store or stores. And then you can try to click it and it will show on the map and can show where it's located. Is it near you or is it too far or what? Oh, okay. No, it's not. So you can, if ever it's putoy, you can try another option. Like from the receipt, 7-Eleven receipt. You can key in the, it says here the number. It's the store number and the name of the store where it's located. There are two types, the name of the store and the other type is the number. Store number. Maybe it's the... Oh, Yan Yan! Okay! Yeah, that's the number. Store number, and then the middle one is the name of the store. It says in translation, it's a painting name. Maybe it's a name, a building name, I don't know. I'm not really sure. I tried to do it on the Google Translator, but it's still very confusing, the other two. This is a street name. This is more easier. Yeah, example in Chilong. And then nearest place have three choices. And then you can just one by one click on that and then check on the map if it's the one or not. Or like this example, this is the correct store. Then okay, click it and then those are the IDs that you will present to the sales clerk in the 7-Eleven. Yeah, these are the reminders that are ID acceptable. Very good here in Taiwan, there are only three kind of very good source of identification. National ID, health ID, and driver's license. And then click OK, OK. And then review the details. Yeah. The red colors, the red font there are like the name and contact number, and it's just a reminder. For the seller, for setting up the buyer this time is, for setting up the buyer is all the same. Key in the name, the number, and the popay. And the email is optional. Email is optional, so usually it's the most important is the name of the buyer and the telephone number and the store where it will be going to be picked up. Oh. Yeah, the same process. It's easier for the street name than the specific name of the store or the number of the store. Store number. For me, I like the street name searching because it's more easier. And then when you're familiar with watching it on the map, then it's easier for you to identify the store. But if you're good in reading Chinese, the street name of the store is okay for you, or number of the store. Yeah, like this one, this is okay, that's the correct store. Okay, you found it, the same process with a buyer. They will just show their ID or identification and then click okay. Before they get, yeah, okay, how bang bang. And then review your details. You can go back, always go back. This is forward to the next step. And then the other side is like backward. Go back to the last step you want to check. And then the middle is print. Print the paper on 7-Eleven. Yeah, check all the details. Is it all correct? Yeah. Oh, still confused? Yeah. These are the options. These are the barcode you can show to the 7-Eleven using your phone. Whether you open it through website or through APP, they will help you print your details. You just go to the 7-Eleven near 7-Eleven that you want to send out your package, and then they will help you print you can self-print if you know how to send the, how do you call that, iCloud printing, or through your APP, and then, or through the iPhone machine itself. There are many choices you can have. And then, but I think the best I can recommend is go to the 7-Eleven you chose to send out your package, and then they will help you send it out. Yeah, we're done. Okay, and next time I will try to make now we are done with mailing. Next time I will make a record of a video about query status, seller order, and